Welcome to Dexerto's Pop Flash, presented by USAA Insurance. I'm Richard Lewis, and today I'm going to be talking about Vitality, who have just won IEM Winter, probably against the odds if we're being honest about it. Now, a strange thing has happened with Vitality since they said that this lineup was going to break up, which was announced as soon as they went out of the PGL Major. They've been playing better than they have for the bulk of the year. It's actually crazy to think that, you know, sure, they go out 5th to 8th at the PGL Major in Stockholm, but I mean, that was pretty good, all things considered, especially with the start they had and the bad position they put themselves in. They got runners-up against NAVI, ended NAVI's nuke streak, Blast Premier Fall, and then they come into IEM Winter and they're going out on a high, potentially winning this tournament, and they're going to be at the Blast Premier World Finals with, you know, they're in with as much of a chance of winning it as winning this, I would say, with, of course, the exception of NAVI being there. But they're peaking right at the end of their life cycle, which is just one of those things that it just generally doesn't happen. You know, there's nothing really left to play for. People are just winding down their contracts. Maybe there's like a little effect where people are in the shop window. You know, we've seen shox linked with Team Liquid quite strongly this past month or so. But I mean, ultimately, what they've done, how they've galvanized, you know, as a core, and the level they're playing at now, kind of makes me sad that the team's actually going to break apart, because I think it puts a lot of pressure on the Danish guys coming in and zonic coming in to sort of continue this success, and it certainly isn't guaranteed, and it certainly might take a while for them to get to the level we all expect them to. But this run, keep in mind, Vitality is meant to be the easy opponent. They're the dead team, right? They're the ones that aren't supposed to put up a fight. They should just turn up to the tournament and go out. The run they had here was ridiculous. Forget the best of ones. They beat NiP back when Device was well enough to play, beat them 2-0. They go up against G2, they take a map there. G2, of course, using a stand-in. G2 hand them a loss. Vitality then go on to beat Gambit, Virtus.Pro, and 3-0 NiP in a best-of-five final. This run's legit. I think they had the hardest run of any of the teams in attendance. And I suppose, even though this team is breaking apart, there's a lot of good news that sort of comes out of this. I mean, first of all, ZywOo gets the MVP. ZywOo himself just played, you know, lights out at this tournament. So I couldn't believe it when I saw it. It was his first MVP of the year, apparently. So he's had a quiet year by his high standards. So him getting back to form, that's positive, because obviously he's still going to be in the lineup when the Danes get there. But I think as well, over the course of the tournament, even if he was a little bit quiet in the finals, Misutaaa actually showed, you know, a lot of maturity despite being a young player. He did an interview, I think, during the tournament where he said he wants to be more than just a pillar of the team, wants to get to the next level. Great attitude, and he had a great showing here. Apex, I think, is not only now a legitimate fragging IGL, but he's an entry fragging IGL. You know, he looked, there were shades of his old self. Now, obviously, Kyojin and shox aren't going to be part of the team anymore. It's not so much of a loss that Kyojin's going out for me. I think that experiment failed. I wish him all the best, but I think he needs to go cut his teeth in Tier 2 before he's ready for another shot in Tier 1. But shox actually rolled back the years as well here, which is, again, sad to think he's not going to be part of this team. But it doesn't happen often, but when it does, shox shows you those little glimpses of the player he used to be, you know, one of the greats of all time. So Vitality here, it's just sad, because they had such a legit map pool. I mean, when you go 3-0 in a best of five, that basically says there that, you know, listen, we're comfortable on all of these maps. You know, they beat NIP on their pick of Inferno in the final. Obviously, Dust 2. You expect the French team to be good on that map for sure. They won out on Nuke, which was NIP's other pick. And what you realize is now, like with the rankings, this Vitality lineup being the number two team in the world, that's actually probably legit, because if you G2 you know, yes, they were using a stand-in. Yes, they didn't have their IGL. I still think they've got to make the finals here. And who knows what would have happened. G2 seemed to have, you know, Vitality's number. And I think certainly they would have put up a better fight than NIP. NIP just seemed to be kind of a little bit lost in general once they got to the, you know, the grand final. Probably were a little bit lucky to even be there, frankly. But you know, I think this team can be immensely proud of what it's doing as well. I mean, this is the toughest situation for a coach to be in. XTAZ, I've said it before on this channel, he is one of the best coaches in terms of skills that we've got in the game. And he's had a real challenge. He's had to bed in new players. He's had to rest his IGL this year. Remember, Apex was out of the team for a little bit, and there seemed to be some tensions between the two. They've come together to work that out, and now they look like the tactical team that you would want to see go up against NAVI. You know, can they beat NAVI? They can, probably 3 times out of 10. You know, that's probably where we're about. But that's as good as anybody in World Counter-Strike right now. And so, listen, XTAZ has got to go to a big team after this. He's proven time and time again what a fantastic coach he is, that he is a leader of men in that classical sense. You know, we saw that at the PGL Major, that, you know, he has this authoritarian streak, but also a great mind for the game. And you kind of wonder, you know, if he was given like a G2, or if he was given a Gambit, or, you know, just a world-class team, what could he do with it? And it's really sad because, yeah, he's getting replaced by the best coach we've ever had, but he certainly doesn't deserve to lose his job. And performances like this absolutely prove it. So, I mean, I was blown away, actually, out of all of the teams that were left in it, when Thorin and Semler and me were sat down talking about it on the last episode of Pop Flash. We were, you know, kind of going through who we thought could win the tournament overall. And, you know, we were talking about, you know, no more excuses for G2. And then it was announced, obviously, they had to use a stand-in. I think right now, Vitality are just good value for second place in the world. And it's crazy to think we're probably going to see them at one more tournament after all of this. Just a phenomenal run. And what a way to kind of cement the legacy on the way out. Definitely looking forward to seeing this atom-smashed Danish-French lineup when it gets here. But I'm going to be really sad to see this Vitality team that have actually bounced back immensely this year. This was a team, by the way, you go back and you look at some of the tournaments, they were bombing out. They were going out like 13th to 16th and stuff. They had real problems. And despite the fact, I think they've got a player that's lacking caliber to pick up a trophy under these circumstances. It's one of the, like, great runs. It's one of the great stories. And no less than these guys deserve. It also, I think, serves as a future lesson for all pros out there that when life gives you lemons, you can make lemonade. You don't have to be like one of these NA crying, you know, childish teams that chuck their toys out the pram and embarrass themselves. Yeah, I'm talking about evil geniuses. You don't have to be like that. You can just do the job and say, listen, you know, sure, it's over for some of us, but we're still contracted. We've still got the fans. We've still got an obligation to the game, to ourselves, and you can still be excellent even under circumstances like this. So mad props to Vitality for this win. It was a hard run, a hard tournament to triumph. To do it like this, you've just got to take your hats off to them. And don't rule them out at the Blast World Finals when those start. They could really end the year on a crazy high if NAVI are a little bit relaxed and get caught cold.